I said that, you know, love has not changed, that we have understood love better because we are breaking away from the typical prototype that we had created for love, that for two people to fall in love, you need to be a certain gender or some age. But today we have understood, or we're trying to understand the true meaning of love, which transcends all boundaries, whether it's gender, whether it's age, whether it's whatever.
You know, the teacher was teaching in the class and this girl entered and it was like a film, puri filmy scene diya. So she entered and I just stopped paying heed in the class. Ki kya padha rahe sir? Main bas usse dekhta ja raha hoon. You know, you just skipped a beat. Your heart just skipped a beat.
In sixth standard, I went and I cut my hair this much. I was like, ab to usse dekhna hi hoga. Like, some difference to he will notice. So something will happen. And I was like, in sixth standard, we got shuffled. He was in another section. So my haircut was wasted.
Hello everyone, welcome to peepingmoon.com. I'm Rashita Sani and today I'm extremely pleased to be chatting with Tahira Kashyap, Meer Ahuja and Kajol Jog for their upcoming Netflix anthology, Feels Like Ish. Tahira, firstly, I would like to ask you that how did you conceptualize a love story based on quarantine? Of course, we have all been there in the past 1 year.
So, Ghazal has written this script and it came to me and I completely fell in love with the idea of how a simple love story and how connections can happen. Especially this was the time when we were in the midst of a lockdown, and right now people have really become well equipped to live in the times today. We know how to adapt ourselves. At that time, there was so much of confusion. People were feeling very aloof and alienated. That's the time when the script came and it made so much sense because beyond love, there was also about connection between two people, and that also set in today's times, which is the pandemic and the quarantine. I loved the basic premise, which was a simple love story set across a gate and the chhat, which kind of I sort of added onto it. I've added a lot from my upbringing, from the world that I grew up in. So you'll see a lot of that in the story, in the characters, in the way they behave at the gate or at the chhat. And it really resonated well with me. And I really wanted to do something very uncomplicated. But most of the uncomplicated things are complicated. It's very difficult to be simple. So, it's relatively easier to have a contrived character with a lot of complexities, a lot of layering and all of that. But when you have a simple character and the hearts are supposed to sort of fall in love with them, it's most difficult to create that. I'm so glad that my characters did that for me. I hope they did do it for the world as well. I quite enjoyed making the film. And I love my two characters, Mihir and Kajol.
Okay, that's great. And Tahira, again for you, how do you define love in simpler words, in a simple manner?
Oh. There's something probably I'll take away with the love from the last interview that I just did, where somebody asked me whether love has changed. I said that, you know, love has not changed, that we have understood love better because we are breaking away from the typical prototype that we had created for love, that for two people to fall in love, you need to be a certain gender or some age. But today we have understood, or we're trying to understand the true meaning of love, which transcends all boundaries, whether it's gender, whether it's age, whether it's whatever. And love is just about between two living, breathing beings.
Okay, agreed. Mihir, your past work that we have seen, it has been completely different than what you're playing in Feels Like Ish. So was it challenging to play, you know, this sort of infatuated character in the anthology?
Of course, it was challenging, but I was excited at the same time because as actors, you just love to play different characters and love to do variant roles. And to be in the shoes of different characters is always fun and challenging. So I won't say it was very challenging, but because the crew and the director and the writer made it very easy. And I'm a Punjabi, so it was very easy for me to, and I have had a lot of Punjabi and Sikh friends in my school. So one of my best friends is a Sardar. So, so So I kind of related very much to the character. I called him, I asked him, ki bhai ye kaise bolu, ye kaise bolu, tu is moment pe kya karta hai, main kya karu bata. So, you know, I just took, jagah jagah se, I just took pointers from my friends. It was not that challenging, but I love playing the character.
Kajol, also in the trailer, you come across as someone who's more confident than Mihir. But was there any, you know, special consideration that you took to ensure that, you know, your character does not come across as someone who's not swayed by the teenager crush and is sort of more serious?
Nimi was in this whole new place. And if I was in that kind of situation, I don't think I would have held my ground or like reacted that way to these sort of, you know, situations. But in a way, I think Nimi is so busy with all the things that she loves. Like, she's starting, like, planting things in the veranda. Then she's creating a new song for herself. She's keeping herself so busy, and she's so, like, happy with all the things that she's already investing her time in. So I think it comes off as she's very, like, you know, confident and very, like, you know, she wouldn't be swayed by him or is very interested in what is exactly happening here in the beginning. And that actually comes through the trailer very well. Like, that, I saw that happening, and even my family and everyone reacted the same way. But I wouldn't say I put in too much effort into that side. It was more about what Nimi is doing inside the house, which Maninder is so interested in. Like, he's constantly looking and trying to figure out what is she doing. I feel like I put in more work there, trying to keep her busy and her mind running all the time. But it comes across as she's, like, very, like, confident and everything.
And this is for everyone, so you all can answer one by one. We are all sure, in fact, that you all must have gone through crushes during your teenage years. Could you share some of your experiences when you, you know, felt that first pang of love, maybe?
Yeah, butterflies all over it, my tummy. And that was my only direction, sort of note to both my actors. Whenever they were falling low on energy, I just used to say, "Titliyan kahan? Where are the butterflies? Where are the butterflies?" So that is the only thing. Yeah, my when I go back to my crush days, I don't know if it's a crush days. I can still have crush, but the time when I had one serious crush, it was. You get heebie-jeebies and all the butterflies that are floating and flying in my stomach. And that's the kind of thing that I relate to. And that's the kind of feeling that comes to me.
I remember I was in seventh grade and that's the time when I had my first crush in my maths tuition. I still remember that day very clearly. I still have a vision of that day. The teacher was teaching in the class and this girl entered and it was like a film, puri filmy scene thi. So she entered and I just stopped paying heed in the class. Ki kya padha rahe sir? Main bas usse dekhta ja raha. You know, you just skipped a beat. Your heart just skipped a beat. It's such a beautiful feeling. And so wo feeling sirf first love ya first crush se hi aati hai. So it is a very different feeling and it is a very it is a magical feeling altogether. So I never got to talk to her much, but you know, I remember this day when I met her in the tuition. So every day I used to groom myself a little more for the class, for the tuition. And my mom would be like, "Nahin, there's something wrong with him. Why is he behaving so odd?" And I used to reach class before time. I was not very punctual in my school days, but I used to reach class before time just for that girl. And I remember this day when the maths teacher was scolding me that, "Where's your notebook? And you didn't do your homework." And I was kind of happy that at least she's getting my attention and at least she's getting to know that I exist. You know, I was blushing when the teacher was scolding me because I kind of thought ki meri presence pata to chal gayi usse ki main hoon, I exist. So yeah, that was my first crush story.
My first crush was actually in fifth standard. And I realized throughout fifth standard, kuch bhaav nahi mila, kuch nahi hua. I was like, at least we should be friends or something should happen. In sixth standard, I went and I cut my hair this much. I was like, अब तो उसे देखना ही होगा, लाइक सम डिफरेंस तो ही विल नोटिस, सो समथिंग विल हैपन. एंड आई वाज लाइक इन सिक्स्थ स्टैंडर्ड वी गॉट शफल्ड, ही वाज इन अनदर सेक्शन, सो माय हेयर कट वाज वेस्टेड. एंड देन आई वुड डू वेरी क्यूट थिंग्स वेयर वी वुड शेयर द हिंदी क्लास टुगेदर. सो व्हेनेवर ही वुड गो टू सबमिट हिज book, even I would go right after him, because then when they give the books back, it will come in the same order. So I would do very cute small things like this just to get his attention. And whenever I think about it, I go back to that, like, you know, me just putting in a little more effort, or like listening to his favorite songs, or going eating where he usually likes eating, just to like get a glance of him. Like, love for me is just a culmination of very little efforts that you put in on the daily, even if they like you back.
Okay, thank you so much, guys, for chatting with us. It was a pleasure talking to you guys. All the very best for Feels Like a Show. Thank you.